What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Destiny, and if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to the family. So this week, I'm going to be giving you guys like a follow-along warm-up exercise. I'm not going to say routine because routines can change, and I feel like it's important to stress the importance of just stretching out the parts of your body that might feel tense or need a little bit more TLC, you know what I mean? So I'm just going to focus on what I feel I need for my body today, but I will help you through some alternatives or some modifications that can help other areas. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's just get right on into it. I'm going to be using a yoga mat because I am outside and I don't want to be sitting on the grass because it was raining just a few days ago. So if you have one, great. If not, it's not the end of the world, so don't worry about it. Okay, let's get started. So first thing we're going to do is open up our mat if we have one. If you are inside, it's not necessary. If you do like the grass and you're doing this outside, by all means, use the grass. It's just that my floor is a little bit wet, so I had to take my mat out today. We're going to do some head rolls first, nice and easy, relaxing the neck and the shoulders about 4 times on each side, taking our time. And you can go a little slower than me. You can always pause this video if you need to. Just work at your own pace. You can also keep your eyes closed if this helps you. I usually keep my eyes closed just to help focus a little bit better and to really focus on my breathing and pinpoint those areas that feel a little bit more tense. After these head rolls, we're gonna do some shoulder rolls. Same idea, keeping the whole body nice and relaxed, focusing on our breathing, and really trying to stretch out those shoulders. While you're doing these shoulder rolls, you can start bending those knees and adding them into the stretch. It really helps to open up the rest of the muscles and allow the body to get ready for the next stretches we're going to be doing. From there, we're just gonna take some arm swings left and right and slowly bring it into a figure eight position and adding our hips and bending the knees, just alternating them side to side. You could do this as many times as you want and chronologically just slow it back down until you come back to center. From here, we're gonna inhale and bring our arms up over our head, down through our chest, and bringing it all the way down into a nice plié. Plié means to bend. So we're just bending those knees all the way down and rolling ourselves back up slowly. Doing this about 4 times or more, whatever feels more comfortable for you, but really allowing the body to take that deep breath in to go up, exhaling while you're coming down, and then slowly bring yourself back up to center. Feel free to take the head with it. Make sure that you're bringing the head all the way down and all the way up in this stretch. So deep breath in, stretching to the sky, hands down the chest, down the thighs, to the floor. Head comes down, relaxing the neck. Slowly rolling back up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Last thing to come up is always the head. Next, we're gonna take a dynamic lateral stretch. So just bringing that right arm up over the head to the side, back down to where we started, and then back over to the side, keeping that left hand on the thigh to make sure that you're really supporting your body. Don't have to go all the way to the side if it hurts too much. You should just go to the point where you're feeling that stretch, make sure that you're breathing, and doing this about 4 times on each side, or 8, whatever you want to do today. And then I'm switching here, going to the opposite side, same rules apply, keeping my breathing, really trying to take that lateral stretch a little farther with each time I go to the side. And it also helps to exhale through the mouth and inhale through the nose. From here, we're gonna take about 8 to 10 lateral twists. So just taking our arms in front of us, holding our hands, and switching left to right, really trying to get that twist in that spine. And from there, we're going to take our arms over our head and bring it kind of in a circle in front of us and back around about 4 times, just to kind of open up that upper back and allow that spine to awaken a little bit more. From here, you can see that I'm starting to widen my stance. We're just gonna do some deep seconds here and just alternating the shoulders, just making sure that you're bouncing and allowing those thighs to open up just a little bit. If the bounce is too much for you, you can always just go side to side, just transferring the weight from one foot to the other. You don't have to go
as deep as I am in the second position. I just am very comfortable with sitting in second position. But if this is something that's a little bit tighter for you, like you have tighter thighs, tighter hamstrings, feel free to lessen up that stretch a little bit. From here, I'm just gonna turn my legs parallel and just do a flat back forward, really focusing on stretching out those hamstrings and make sure that you're not holding too much tension in the neck. From there, I'm just gonna add some plie, still in that same position. So I'm just making sure to track my knees forward. You don't want the knees to go in or outwards, just straight forward. If this is a little bit difficult for you, pick up your back just a little more. From there, I'm just taking my arms straight behind me just to get a little extra stretch. This is optional. And keeping the legs straight, we're just gonna bring our hands straight to our right side, still with a flat back, and just adding some bends in that left leg. Alternating from side to side, going about 4 times on each, or 8, whatever you want to do today. And then just bring the head forward along with the arms and just shake your head no and yes, just to kind of relax that neck just a little bit more. Now that we've awoken our back a little bit, our hamstrings and our neck, we're just going to move on to lunges. So I'm just going to take my legs out. I'm going to go onto my right leg, starting with the right leg lunge, and just kind of pulsing forward and back, just to kind of get my hips ready for the position that we're about to sit in. From there, just gonna take your hands onto the top of your thigh and just hold it there. This is a little bit uncomfortable. You don't have to keep both hands up. You can feel free to put one hand on the ground and the other on your knee. If you want a little bit more of a challenge, you can always bring that back leg down to the mat or the grass, whatever surface you're on today, and just pulsing the pelvis forward. If you want more of a challenge, feel free to bring that back leg up and touch the toe. It's gonna hurt a little bit more. I only tend to hold this for a few seconds and then bring it back up to my normal lunge. After we're done with that side, we're gonna come back to center, do a few plies, relax the neck, and then transfer to the other side. So now we're on the left, doing the same thing, rocking forward and back, bringing the hands up to the knee or not, whatever is most comfortable for you. And then bringing that leg in the back a little bit down if that's what you want to do. If not, feel free to just stay in that lunge and just breathe through it. And this is the perfect time to do a quick body scan. A body scan means to just close your eyes and notice any areas of your body that still feel a little bit tense, a little bit more uncomfortable, so that you can pinpoint those areas and try to stretch them out a little bit better. If you feel your right hip's a little bit more tense, you might want to stretch out a little bit deeper on that side and vice versa. Just be very specific with your body and take notice of points that might feel a little bit more sore than others. Come back to center, do some pliés, relaxing that neck. And just like we did earlier today, bring your head all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae, so that we can come back to where we started. Make sure that you're taking it slow, really going up vertebrae by vertebrae, breathing and allowing yourself to take time and space. From there, we're just gonna go down our right leg very slowly, just trailing our hands down and trying to aim to bring our nose to our knee. This is not logical for some people. Not everyone has the same flexibility, but the goal is to get that pathway of the nose to the knee. So as long as you are trying to get that pathway, you're doing it correctly. So just make sure that you're really trying and taking notice of any areas that feel a little bit tense. From there, we're just gonna sit down and bring our right leg over our left in a sitting position and just bring our arms to the opposite side and just taking a nice lateral sitting stretch. Breathing, taking notice of the areas around you. If you're outside, feel free to look at the sky. Really just take your time and be in space with yourself and your body. Just alternating sides, so make sure that you're doing it on both ends, really taking your time. I'm not gonna give you a certain amount of time to sit in this position. I usually do about an 8 count. Sometimes I just count to 30, whatever I feel like I wanna do that day. And after that, we're just gonna sit straight on the mat. And while we're on the floor, just think about your body going into the floor. Don't try to tense any muscles. Just allow yourself to sit down and relax. Give yourself some self-massage. I'm working on my thighs, my arms, some upper back. But if you need to work on other areas, feel free to do that. You can cross your legs if you need to. Sit in any position that's most comfortable for your body. And just take your time with it. Make sure you're breathing and just be alert. Just give yourself some time and be in the space with yourself. now that we're done with the massage, we'll just bring our legs back out in front of us if we had them crossed, and just start to trail your arms down towards your feet, trying to keep your back as straight as possible to the last second, and just keep on going back and forth, kind of undulating down to your knees and back up to sitting. And just do about 4 of these. Feel free to do 8 if it feels really nice in your back or your hamstrings. And then we're just going to come back up to standing. Feel free to just shake out the arms and legs if you need to. Fix your clothing, whatever you need. And then just take a big deep breath like we did earlier, bringing the arms up to the sky, clasping the hands and rotating just so that you can get a nice arm and hand stretch. From there, we're just going to take our arms to the side of us and just swing lateral twists like we did earlier, just letting the arms flare out. From here, we're going to take a simple quad stretch, just bringing that right leg behind us and clasping the hand on the foot. Feel free to clasp both hands if you want an extra challenge for balance. And just make sure that you're breathing and trying to keep that balance. After that, we're just going to alternate and bring it in front of us. So we have a back stretch and now we have a forward stretch. So really getting into those quads. After that side, we're just going to repeat the same thing to the left leg, clasping with the hand or both, and then bringing it forwards in front of us, continuing breathing and taking our time. From there, we're just going to take our right leg and just do some leg circles with the knee bent and the foot flexed. And if this is a little bit difficult for you, try not to bring the leg up as high, especially for people that have really tight hips or their hips are not as open. Make sure you're really bringing it to a point where it's comfortable for you. You do not want to overcompensate or try too much. It just wants to be comfortable, relaxing, and just a little bit of a discomfort. Here, I'm just bringing back the lateral twists, except we're not going to be going many times to one side, and we're just going slightly deeper than before since we're way warmer than when we first started. This is not much of a stretch, but I think of it more as an energy release. Just take your knuckles and glide them across your chest, making sure you're taking deep breaths in and out. Feel free to close your eyes for this. You just want to run your knuckles down nice and gently, but with enough pressure to where you feel it. And just close your eyes and release any type of negative energy that you might be bottling up inside today. Anything that's bringing you discomfort or is making you anxious. This really does help me ground myself. And it's been making me feel so much better when I add it to my stretch routine. So I highly recommend doing things like this for yourself, taking time to really just be with yourself in space with no one around and just allowing yourself to take care of your body. Exercise is really important, and I know it can be a little bit intimidating when you have no one to really push you. I know that it can be so hard to do it when it's just you by yourself, but let me know if you guys want more videos like these and we could do it together. So let me know. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you got some release from this and that it was helpful for you, especially for people that don't stretch too often. I hope it was easy enough to follow along to. And if you did partake in today's activities, make sure that you do stay hydrated and drink some water today. I love you guys so much and thank you a million for over 21,000 subscribers. Like a damn I hold my heart out to all of you that watch my videos, and I'm so grateful for each and every one of you, so thank you so much. And that is the end of today's video. I hope you guys feel a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more loosey-goosey. Let me know if you guys want more videos like this. I really enjoy making more dance-related content. So if you enjoy these videos, let me know. But until then, make sure that you are subscribed. If you're not, it's okay. It's a good opportunity to now though. So if you want to be updated with any of my upcoming videos, make sure that you hit that little notification bell so that you can get notified every time I post a new video. Until next time, guys. Bye.